writer. Everybody who's a writer first. I don't care if you're a writer director, a writer producer, a writer actor, you're a writer first.
So, what was the first project you wrote?
The first film I ever wrote was a little service movie called The Sleep Ride that I graduated on to James Bond. I wrote Diamonds Are Forever and Live and Let Die and Man with the Golden Gun. The final draft of Superman, Superman 2. Put a series on the air called Heart to Heart. I wrote and directed the 2-hour movie with the pilot. And I wrote and directed the movie with Dan Aykroyd and Tom Hanks called Dragon.
Not so bad. Fun movie. So, you've been through strikes before?
Yes, I'm trying to count. I think this is my fourth strike. So, what's the impact of the Guild has had on your life and what you've seen? Have you seen the benefits? The Guild is like simply a life changer for every life. It not only protects you in so many different areas, and collects residuals on your work, research, all of it, but it's an absolute vital necessity in this business.
Wow.
And so many people have such a vested interest in taking so much away from you as they can.
What do you have to say about what you're seeing in terms of unity and cooperation now compared to then? And
I think the spirit in this strike is the best spirit from the Guild that I've seen in any of the strikes I've been through. And I think one of the reasons is that the leadership of the Guild this time is, and I believe, properly militant and properly motivated, that we don't fall into the trap we have before by getting six every time in our settlement and then striking to get back what we already have and let go. And so I'm just hoping that this will be a very thorough settlement that will cover all areas, because we should be all collaborating. The studios, the producers, the directors, the writers, we all are all necessary to the function. And even to make sound, I don't see why you can't all get along. A writer writes, or a team of writers in your feet, pitches the movie, writes the television episodes, creates the series. And they shouldn't properly compensate for it in every area. I've never understood this thing where the studio is going to say, well, we don't know what the revenue stream is going to be yet. My point is, if we're asking for, let's say, 2.5 cents, if you guys get $10, we make 25 cents. You make $100 million, we make $2.5 million. You don't make any money, we don't make any money. It's irrelevant what the revenue stream is. We want and deserve a certain piece of it.
Now, I've heard some other talks and discussions about people how screenwriters and television writers are very different from playwrights and book authors who retain their copyright.
Absolutely. I mean, there are advantages and disadvantages. Most novelists and playwrights, most, not all, don't get big advances. A screenwriter is paid in front for his or her screenplay, or at least partly paid in front. But those screenplays wind up being the property of the people who write them.
Thoughts or comments about we're all in this together?
Well, we are all in this together, and I think what I see is the number of people who've been laid off, writers, the secretaries, the assistants, the people, they're not on strike against anybody. They're not going to get a settlement. They live paycheck to paycheck, and I really think that whatever settlement we finally arrive at, it will be a settlement we could have arrived at earlier. So I just hope that everybody works very hard to get settled.
Thank you so much.